Today's testing at Anglesey is deliberate, to show you the amount of effort that Nissan's total body has put into the Pintara. However, the proving ground is only 2 years in our story. The Pintara story started some 4 years ago, and today I'd like to tell you about it. Pintara is an all-new car concept in the Australian medium-sized car market. It's the most complete expression yet of the things that today's drivers are looking for in the family car. It combines the smoothness and efficiency of electronic fuel injection with a range of features and fitments top in its class, in fact almost unexpected in its class. And all of this goes together with handling and braking that is supreme. Also, added to all this are new levels of quality previously only found in imported vehicles. Simply put, we can add one final word, quietness. All of this goes together to give Nissan new levels of reputation in reliability and value. Nissan Pintara is our answer to today's family driving needs. Considerable market research, plus a major Australianisation program, has resulted in a vehicle well able to handle tough Australian driving conditions. As a result, Pintara is to be aimed at groups of people who previously did not recognize Nissan was capable of offering a luxury vehicle in this range. Research showed that the major requirements were mechanical reliability, riding and driving comfort, handling and road holding, value for money, and please don't forget this one, quality. That research came up some 4 years ago. Now, the Australianisation program reacted to that research and gave us the following major points. Engine performance, but with electronic fuel injection as standard. Safety, both primary and secondary, by combining four-wheel disc brake standard with a structurally much stronger vehicle. Handling, which I believe is very close to rally standards, and then it's all being topped off with a list of interior features aimed at providing for those discerning buyers, shown by research, exactly what they want. However, the most important word for Pintara is quality. Pintara comes in both sedan and wagon body styles. Both sedan and wagon have GXE variants and GX versions. Now, they all share the same electronic fuel injection. And you'll notice from the first time that you drive this vehicle, and you must drive it, the smoothness, the refined response, and the quietness. The engine is a CA20 engine. The Nissan 2-litre four-cylinder CA20E engine with twin spark plug features electronic fuel injection as standard on all Pintaras. This engine has been tuned to maximum performance and efficiency with unleaded petrol, giving further proof to Nissan's superior know-how in unleaded petrol technology. But as with all things mechanical, the only way to truly appreciate them is to use them. So let's drive it. Again, I have to immediately remark on the smoothness and quietness of this engine, but the best thing now is the improved power with the engine in Pintara with the unleaded petrol technology. 5-speed gearbox is standard on Pintara, very smooth and very light. The automatic transmission, which is available as an option on all models, is 4-speed overdrive, highly fuel efficient, very fast. And what's best about it is that our engineers had the opportunity to tune the little chip that controls gear change points specifically for Australian driving conditions. But let's position the vehicle before we go any further. Let us see how the public will view Pintara and what market segment it will satisfy. Pintara is targeted at traditional family buyers in the medium market segment, but will represent a new choice because of its key strengths, which are design and build quality, the high level of comfort and convenience features, its fresh, different styling will be noticed on the road, plus the strength and reliability of traditional front engine rear drive configuration makes it ideal for towing, and this is a requirement for some 60% of this market segment. Pintara is aimed at the private buyer, who wants luxury, quality, comfort, and reliability with fresh styling on which to base a value-for-money purchase. Pintara's nearest competitor will be Toyota Corona Avanti, not so much as a vehicle, more as a market objective. So first, let's see how we compare on interior space. Pintara has more front interior space, more leg, head, and shoulder room than Corona. It's a similar story in the rear. We have more interior seat space than Corona. And our wheelbase is longer by 110 millimeters than Corona for greater stability, a smoother ride, and greater passenger comfort. We have 50 millimeters wider front track and 56 millimeters wider track than Corona for more interior space, easier steering, greater road holding, and again, greater passenger comfort. Pintara also boasts four-wheel disc brakes as standard for safer, surer stopping, another exclusive feature for Pintara in the medium car segment. Please remember, primary safety is achieved with a vehicle capable of avoiding an accident, that is, good handling and good brakes, and that secondary safety comes from a strong vehicle that will save you after an accident. Pintara is tops in both of these areas of safety. Whilst we don't position Pintara as a racy performer, it is worth pointing out to your prospects that we have 9% more power than the Corona 2-litre engine and 5% more torque. But you really must drive it for yourselves. However, in the meantime, have a short look at 2 years of testing from the boys at Clayton. Well, there's some great information there, but it's in comforts and convenience items that Pintara really stands out. Its instrumentation say at once both modern and sophisticated. The Pintara has a comprehensive range of instrumentation with trip meter, fuel gauge, temperature gauge, warning lights for brake fluid level, handbrake and door ajar, plus an exclusive tachometer not found on vehicles such as Corona 2-litre. Pintara GXE has all of this, plus voltage and oil gauges, low fuel warning lamp and seatbelt warning lamp. Open the door to Pintara GX, and you open the door to that comfort and convenience. The driver's seat has an exclusive feature not found on Corona, an adjustable lumbar support for precise and individual support. And notice another exclusive, full cloth seat trim, not just cloth inserts, plus cloth door trim, a luxury exclusive not found on Corona. Pintara GX sedan and wagon feature a high quality AM FM stereo radio cassette deck as standard equipment. They also have a digital clock. There's even a driver's footrest for minimum body strain on those tedious trips. Map pockets are standard, and Pintara has a tilt-adjustable steering column, standard and highly promotable. Another exclusive is our remote fuel lid release. Pintara has an illuminated ignition switch for easy key location at night, plus illuminated ashtray, glove box, cigarette lighter and heater controls. And we have intermittent wipers for safety and convenience. Do notice that in the park position, the wipers are lifted off the screen to preserve blade life. Pintara GX has a rear console box to conveniently hold small items. And another handy exclusive over Corona, power left and right hand exterior rear view mirrors. And don't forget that rear seat passengers have not been forgotten either. Pintara has rear seat armrest, another exclusive not found on Corona, plus more legroom, more headroom and more shoulder room, both in front and back. And remember, Pintara has standard electronic fuel injection, plus 5-speed all-synchromesh transmission as standard. Well, that's quite an impressive package of features for what is, after all, our lowest specification vehicle. Now, let's have a look at Pintara GXE, both sedan and wagon, and see how they take us one step further into the land of luxury. Power steering is standard, one further step ahead of the others. Pintara GXE has the ultimate sound center, a digital AM, FM, stereo radio cassette deck with 4 speakers, plus rear passenger headphones, plus a power antenna. GXE seats have all the design benefits we've seen in Pintara GX seats, plus adjustable front headrests and driver's seat height adjustment. Pintara GXE also has the luxury and comfort of rear seat headrests, plus rear seat armrest, not on Avanti. GXE has luxury velour seat trim, an exclusive full cloth door trim, again not found on Avanti. Your prospects will be impressed with Pintara GXE's carpet kick pads and luxury carpet throughout. A useful GXE convenience item is the map lamp. Pintara GXE sedan also has the convenience of a remote boot release and the safety and convenience of variable intermittent wipers, another exclusive over Avanti. The luxury of cloth headlining complements Pintara GXE's velour and carpet look of complete luxury. And for passenger safety and convenience, GXE has doorstep, footwell lamps, and time delay interior lighting. Well, that's a lot of information for you to take in, but I still say that the only way to understand Pintara is to drive it. So come along. Well, the quietness of the ride and the lack of engine noise has been taken to new levels. I don't think they've ever been associated with a vehicle in Pintara's size range before. I think that's evidence of Nissan's quality in this first of a new class from Nissan. It's a major Nissan advantage. It'll provide a clincher, I think, to many Pintara sales. It's important to understand how we achieve this level of quietness and sophistication. And the story is very similar to Navara. The basic body strength of Pintara is so strong that noise cannot pass into the passenger compartment. Remember that Pintara's upmarket prospects expect quietness and sophistication in the car they drive. So make a feature of it when you take test drives with Pintara. This is a car that welcomes both driver and passenger. It's a car that is particularly rewarding if you have an eye for detail. It's packed with the kinds of features that the market want but can't always find. And in fact, it's more than likely that in the Pintara GXE, they'll have features they've never even thought of before. And you'll see an array of equipment and features worthy of cars costing thousands more. For example, the rear stereo headsets on the GXE. The Pintara GXE measures up as one of the most luxurious driving environments one could hope to meet. The room will surprise and please. The quiet, smooth ride will relax. The quality will impress. In fact, it's truly high-class accommodation. Nissan know-how dictates that every vehicle we build should not only perform its function well, but reward both the driver and the passenger alike. Therefore, there really is no such thing as a basic Pintara. The GX is the Pintara in its most affordable form. Pintara GX comes complete with the 2-litre electronically fuel-injected engine and the 5-speed transmission that powers this Pintara GXE. And I can quite assure you, you stop straight and sure with disc brakes on all four wheels. Whilst we've been making comparisons today against Corona as our target competitor, it's important to know that we have big pluses against other competition such as Telstar and Magna. Now, let's have a look at the Pintara GX to see how that compares to such likely competition. Pintara has an exclusive that makes for smooth performance and easier hot or cold starts, electronic fuel injection. This is not available on Corona CS, Telstar GL, or Magna GLX, who all have the old-style carburation. Specification advantages of Pintara GX over Corona CS include 5-speed gearbox as standard, 4-wheel disc brakes, power mirrors, remote fuel lid release, lumbar support in driver's seat, rear seat armrests, full cloth seat trim, tilt-adjustable steering column, a tachometer, digital clock, and cloth door inserts. When we compare Pintara GX with Ford Telstar GL, we find these specification advantages. 5-speed gearbox as standard, 4-wheel disc brakes, power mirrors, rear seat armrest, not on Telstar, full cloth seat trim, driver's footrest, tachometer, door ajar lamp, full boot carpeting, again not on Telstar, and cloth door inserts. The same size engine, both 2-litre, but Pintara has the advantage of electronic fuel injection. Looking to Mitsubishi Magna, we see it's a bigger car with more power, a 2.6 litre. But still, we outfeature it. Pintara has power mirrors, not on Magna. Rear seat armrests, again not on Magna. Full cloth seats, driver's footrest, wheel covers, cassette as standard, cloth door inserts, and none of these items again are on Magna. Pintara has wide body side mouldings, plus split folding rear seats and door pockets. Comparing Pintara GXE with its probable rivals, we find a similar story with features and fitments. Pintara is way ahead. Look at the pluses we have over Corona Avanti. Variable intermittent wipers, full cloth door trim, map light, split rear seat armrest, voltmeter, rear headset, power steering, and adjustable tilt steering column. In comparison with Ford Telstar gear, we have the advantages of variable intermittent wipers, power antenna, rear headset, power steering, yes, that's standard on Pintara GXE, oil and volt gauges, and full cloth door trim. Looking at the Magna SE model, we see that we have the advantages of power mirrors, oil gauge, time delay interior lights, rear headset, power steering, power antenna, wide body side moulding, and split folding rear seat. Well, you've had to absorb an awful lot of detail today, but in fact Pintara can be summed up in just one word, and that word is quality. First of all, quality of design. We've deliberately moved up from 200B and Bluebird type vehicles to Pintara. Quality of build. Clayton have promised us CBU quality out of the local plant. Quality of features. Well, as you know, we don't even offer a GL vehicle. And quality of durability. When Pintara gets onto the second-hand market, we expect it to set new resale records. And when we come to the final commitment, the one from you, we want quality of salesmanship so that you can carry our message to the buying public. And you know, when we talk about the buying public, it's interesting that within Nissan, we expect every year that the management group create an objective for the year. Within my department, our objective for 1986 was to return pride of ownership to the Nissan buyer. With Pintara, we think we've done it. Now, if after you drive the car, you don't agree, ring me up. My number's in the book. Summer life, come and dine. Yes and no.